Gaming is always rapidly changing, from introducing new ideas and mechanics through indie games or the more conventional play-it-safe AAA titles, gaming always finds a way to stay fresh and innovative. However, in my opinion, nothing shows how far gaming has come more so than the wonderful world of VR. And as VR becomes more mainstream with new headsets like the Valve Index and the Oculus Quest, it's now more important than ever to have a new recognizable set of games that can easily appeal to a broad market while still carving their own path and adding something fresh to the VR scene. And I am extremely happy to report that The Walking Dead: Saints and the Sinners does exactly that. The game draws you in with an absolutely gripping cutscene as you play as the tourist, a survivor who takes no stuff here in the city of New Orleans. You're traveling through via kayak in search for The Reserve, a place where dreams are made of. The Reserve is rumored to have bundles upon bundles of weapons, enough food to last you months, and medical supplies to last you what could feel like forever. So after hearing an older fellow out, you two make plans to get to this reserve together. Sadly, when you arrive at the meeting location, you see that he suffered an ambush. He didn't quite survive, and he gives you some radio codes and a partner to stay in contact with, named May. Together with the radio voice and May, it's up to you to piece together the secrets of the reserve, find out what's brewing between these two rival factions named the Tower and the Reclaimers, and most importantly, stay away from being devoured by the dead. Surprisingly, the story is very well done. Despite some so-so voice acting and repeated enemy dialogue, this story is intriguing, striking, and full of twisted turns that you can actually create. The game is a choose-your-own-adventure narrative. Your choices impact the game in both minor and major ways, while still staying linear in the mission structure. The story has great pacing, fun characters, and plenty of breadcrumbs and notes to pick up throughout the open world, further exploring the lore in this post-apocalyptic New Orleans. I love how the story is told through diegetic means. Scribbling on walls, tracking footprints, finding notes and photographs, these are all perfect ways to ground us into the VR space. Yes, it's still a game, but physically being able to pick up these items and examine materials front to back while exploring these mini open hubs is a great way of really immersing us in the world. Needless to say, a Walking Dead game once again knocks it out of the park in terms of storytelling, and thankfully, the gameplay follows suit. The game is an open hub survival game. You spend the bulk of your time looking for loot, salvaging items, and crafting various weapons, medicines, and food to keep your health and stamina at its max capacity, while keeping yourself armed to the teeth. Combat boils down to using either melee combat weapons or ranged guns or bows and arrows. The weapon variety, albeit a bit generic in the gun department, really shines in the diversity with the melee weapons. It was definitely a welcome change of pace, moving between saw blades and baseball bats with nails put on them, and often going between your typical dagger-like things like a kitchen knife and a shiv. The game really rewards crafting weapons and making sure you always are on the tip of your toes. Weapons break easily, guns can jam, and for many melee objects, the durability is quite low. If you want to increase the durability of your weapons, you have to craft them. They end up lasting much longer than the ones you pick up off of dead enemies or scattered throughout the open hubs. The core combat loop is incredibly satisfying. Gripping walkers with the grip button and stabbing their brains out or lining up the perfect headshot will never not feel oh so perfect. Sneaking around heavily guarded human areas and getting perfect knife kills and dodging and weaving gunfire is nothing short of a white knuckle thrill ride. The enemy AI for the most part is smart and tactical, often using the house to hide themselves in doorways, swarm your position, or straight up retreat during intense combat sequence, oftentimes when there's walkers about. Now, to be fair, the AI is a little bit on the cheap side. For example, instantly spotting you when you are, you know, so much as peek around a corner, or just getting stuck in staircases or doorways often kinda takes away from the immersive VR space. Thankfully, this doesn't happen too often to the point of bothering, but it is something I do think I should mention. The areas are split into 9 different hubs, each with their own biomes ranging from shipyards and ports to school gyms and rundown suburbs. The locations are varied and deliberately designed, each spawning in unique loot and caches on an in-game day-to-day basis, creating for a slightly roguelike experience. Gameplay stays tense as a timer on your wristwatch constantly ticks down, warning you of the church bell alarm. When this alarm goes off, hundreds of walkers will swarm your position, and the NPCs scatter like cockroaches to avoid the streets flooding with the undead. You have to rush to complete your objectives, grab your loot, and get the heck out as fast as possible. This gameplay system of managing your stamina and health and and time as you make your way through dilapidated buildings and streets infested with walkers always allows for a perfect blend of balancing your stress and tension along with your wits and intuition. Checking every corner as you enter buildings and carefully sneaking around outposts makes for some top tier gameplay. Sure, it still follows many traditional gameplay tropes. For example, the bulk of the game objectives are fetch quests or meet up location points, but it's the way you get to complete those objectives and the amount of freedom you have to get them done that causes the players to come back for more. Exploring is varied as well, with plenty of crawl spaces and climbing spots to help you peek in and out of windows and hallways. There's never a dull moment when it comes to exploring the world of New Orleans. Graphically speaking, the game is outstanding. The art style on display here does a great job of making the walkers look disturbing and inhuman, while giving each human character a sense of style you'll never forget. It takes influence from the Telltale and comic book world of The Walking Dead, which is a nice break from the gritty, realistic textures we usually endure in VR. Each area has a pretty slick watercolor look to things, and the cel shading goes a long way making the visuals stand out. Lighting and architecture design is on point as well. Nothing beats creeping through these poorly lit houses or catacombs, holding onto your shiv in one hand and a flashlight in the other as you take down walkers with one glorious stab. Or you could use the flashlight and pistol and tangent with each other. All in all, it adds to the atmosphere and the lighting. Plus, the fog effects do a wonderful job of further making this VR world all the more immersive. Saints and Sinners is seriously my favorite VR game, from the never-ending amount of content and exploration the game provides to the carefully crafted and surprisingly heartwarming story. Saints and Sinners was a blast to play through, and I enjoyed every single second of it. I really recommend you pick this one up, no matter what platform you get it on. Currently, it's on the PC VR headsets, soon to come to the PlayStation VR headsets, and quarter third of 2020 coming to the Oculus Quest. If you do have an Oculus Rift S or an Oculus Quest already, you're playing the game with Oculus Link, I very much recommend buying it on the Oculus Store, mainly because you're going to be able to use crossplay, which means you can play on both the Oculus PC version and the Oculus Quest version eventually when it releases, which is going to be a huge benefit, albeit a bit of downgrade in visuals when it eventually moves over to the Quest. And again, that is going to do it for this video, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed any of this VR content, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below. If you're interested in VR in any way and have any questions you want to throw my way, again, please comment down below. I'm very much looking forward to answering them, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. See you guys next time. Peace.